stand by for action.
Thanks, gentlemen. My name is Dave Milner. I am the Unpleasant Blind Guy, and I want to welcome you to part 3 of this episode of the Unpleasant Blind Guy on EDL Radio. Now remember, if you want to contact me with comments, questions, show suggestions, Awesome American suggestions, I'm available at UBG Contact on Twitter, or I can also be found as Dave Milner or Agador, that's A-G-G-E-D-O-R, on Mublet, the Tea Party Community, Spreely, Minds, MeWe, or Gab. Now let's begin.
And there you are, folks. That was our star, Jeff Spider Mitchell, talking on Sunday Long Live Radio on the 15th. That's the first part of it. We'll have a second part. Jeff, you got what kind of comments do you have, brother?
I don't know, really. Everything I said is what we talk about week in, week out, Dave.
Right.
And it's talking to other people and just putting your points over. And, you know, it was just spontaneous, really. I called in. I just wanted to congratulate Ray and the great show that she was having. And we got into a great conversation. And, of course, it shed more light on things that was going on. And, of course, you know, that's what people want to see. They want to know the truth, though. They're fed up with being fobbed off by mainstream media crap. That's why when you get, you know, like Ray Bowes, a radio show like that, we're talking about all the things that we talk about. It's a breath of fresh air, isn't it, Dave? It really is. And that's why I called in. And I really enjoyed. She's a lovely lady, you know what I mean? And it was so easy to talk to her. And it was great, some of the points that she was putting forward as well, Dave. And I like that. I like that spontaneous thing, you know, when you're talking and you're engaging with people. And especially Ray, she's a great lady. I hope to talk to her again in the very near future. You know, she puts a great show on. I mean, I think it starts about 9 and I think it finishes around 5 o'clock in the afternoon. You know, it's always great for anybody to tune in to the live radio show. That is awesome. I told you I'd plug you, right? Didn't I, doll? I said I'd plug you.
Yeah. Well, you know, I've got to say, I have a few generalized comments to make about actually the presentation and everything. You know, but I just want to say, Jeff, you know, as a representative of the EDL, you know, you went out into this other format and did a great job, man. You know, I mean, it was a pleasure to listen to you, man. And everybody, you know, Jeff, if you're ready, we'll go ahead and play the second part of this here. All right. Just let me know if you're ready to rock and roll. All right, guys. Now, this is going to be the second part of Jeff's call-in, which turned into an interview and a very nice one on Sunday Long Live Radio. All right. This was on the 15th. And I'm going to go ahead and play this. Here we go. You are listening to the English Defense League radio show.
Say, with your radio show, I do a radio show at night. Myself, I've got a radio show. I'll be talking about Tommy this evening. Basically, we get right around the world online radio, as you do. I'll be talking about a new radio show that I've heard today, which I will say, yes, Steve, it's brilliant. So I'm going to give you a plug on the radio show tonight. Okay.
Come on, you've got to plug your show, darling. Come on, let's have it. Spit
well,
it out.
It's the English Defence League radio show. I've been doing it for 7 years. In fact, Tommy and Kev, it was first called the East Anglian's EDL radio show. They liked it so much, they wanted it as a national radio show. So I've kept it going, even with Tommy and Kev left. And I've seen people come, I've seen people go, but... I stuck to the mission statement. The mission statement, I wouldn't have signed up for it unless it meant that much to me. And I knew something like this, the English Defence League would come along. You know, I've been a spokesman. I was at Norwich. I was a spokesman for the EDL that day with the BBC, ITV. I've been to other demonstrations where I was a speaker. I had a friend of mine come over from Canada. We were speaking to the media that day. So, I've been on a lot of demonstrations, and I've been watching Tommy as when he walked away. And I knew the truth. I knew Tommy didn't walk away because it was to do with anything to do with the Nazis. He had to. His family had been threatened, you know, and his wife and his children. The grey suits threatened them. And that's it. I know he's always had, his heart's always been there for the EDL. And I remember him sitting amongst these Muslims. And the look on his face, that was a broken-hearted man. And same with Kevin. I know Kevin. I've met him at a meet and greet, and what a wonderful guy he is as well. And I see the same with him. And it just had to be done. Well, the threats must have been really imminent for Tommy to do that. And I knew everybody would go, oh, no, he's a traitor. No, he's not a traitor. Far from it. Would you walk in his shoes? Could anybody walk in Tommy Robinson's shoes? You know, it takes a man of courage and bravery. I do believe with Tommy, this was like a calling. He might not have even known it, but it was a calling that someone like him had to come to the forefront and to take on what's going on in this country. And thank goodness. And I hope all the listeners keep Tommy and his family in your prayers, because Belmarsh Prison.
Believe me.
Put it for me, Belmarsh Prison is a tough, tough prison. And so, anything could happen. And that's why a lot of people turned up. And Danny Tomo, guess who was there? Russ Kemp?
Yeah, we played it at the beginning.
Yeah, Russ Kemp. Wow, how coincidental that Russ Kemp was there the week that Tommy was put in Belmarsh. Wow, is that a coincidental thing or what? And Russ Kemp was inside the prison doing his thing. Not being funny, I just think it's hypocritical, really truly. And I do think it was planned out for something like that to happen, like, you know.
Totally, let me jump in there. Because you're doing the EDL thing, the English Defence League, while you're there, let me ask, give me the two primary tenets of the EDL. What is the EDL? Because it gets a lot of bad press, doesn't it? Come on.
Oh, wait, I was that.
Totally. So what are your primary tenets, as it were, for the English Defence League?
It's exactly what it was set up, if the core values of what Tommy set it up for, to expose evil out there, to expose, go to places where people, you know, refuse to go because it's dangerous, to speak out, to do speeches at places where young kids are being raped, groomed and passed around, and we speak. We are the voices of the kids that can't speak out. We want to be the judge. We want to bring justice to these children. That's why I'm in it for the long haul. You know, 10 years now the EDL's been formed, and of course it gets bad press. But more bad press it gets, the more our numbers grow. So thank you for all the bad press, all the mainstream media.
No, we just grow.
We love it. Just keep pouring on, because people like yourself, love, and other people know. That's not the truth. I'm just me. I'm just a working class man. I love my country. I love my grandchildren. I love my great grandchildren. And it concerns me what's been going on to the poor kids across this country. The raping, the grooming, and of course the violence involved with these kids. You've heard some horrific stories of branding children on the bum with an M.
Yeah,
you've heard
yeah.
of having their tongues nailed to a table. You know, and of course, let's not forget Lucy, I can't remember her name, but her and her family were burnt to death because of one of these Muslims decided to set her out. So she knew too much and she didn't want to be involved with them anymore. So they decided to set her home alight, kill her sister and her mother. So of course, people like myself, other people like me, and the patriots across the world. I'm talking about global patriots. We're standing up, we're fighting. We will, I'll tell you what, we will win in the end, no matter what they try. The deep state, the darkness out there, we are the light that's shining through. Every single, in your show, your radio show, is that beacon of light that shines through, that real people are listening to the radio show. So onward and forward. And thank you for taking my call today. You're a lovely lady.
You're very kind. You can come any time. Hey, I think you're a great...
Well, I certainly will. I will probably ring into your show once every Sunday. I might not try to keep as long because you've got other callers out there as well.
Oh, know? It's a good... I think it's a really lovely thing. It's real, it's spontaneous, it resonates, and because of the EDL gets such a bad rap. And like you say, it sort of turned it into a good thing in a way because that's the kind of publicity you can't buy. At the same time, I think to have a representative voice for the English Defence League and to cut through the bad press, I think you're doing a fine job. Hey, Jeff, I'm going to leave you to it. There's loads of stuff going on.
Yeah, thank you. That was a great show. Thank you so much. It's appreciated, those words. And you can call me. I'm a veteran EDL man. I had awarded me two veteran badges going back a number of years ago. One of the guys is not with us anymore. He died of cancer a little while ago. Mark Dunbar, a good friend of mine. But they handed me. I was promoted, believe it or not. They promoted me, and they gave me two veteran EDL badges and my EDL radio show T-shirt.
Is there a lot of military in the EDL, is there?
Well, ex-military.
Well, ex-military, that's what I mean, yeah.
Yeah, but there always has been. We've always been closely associated with what's going on with veterans and that. We've done that right from the beginning. From when Tommy, jumped over the barrier at that time and pulled that black flag out of that Muslim's hands. This was all about the military, the Vikings returning home and being abused by the Muslim mob there. So this is, we've always had that military thing, and always will do, you know, support. So as I say, my friend who passed away a little while ago, he was a hardcore soldier, and I've done a tribute to him on the show because he was, if he had something to say, you'd say if you liked it or not, you know.
Where can people find you, Jeff? Like Jeff, where can people come and listen to you, when, where, and all that kind of stuff?
I broadcast two times a week, Thursdays and Sundays at half past eight. I have an hour and a half show, sometimes I extend it, and you can find me on blogtalkradio.com, just put in English Defence League Radio Show, and you'll find me. If you go to our website, www.englishdefenceleague.org.uk, there's always, I'll be embedded on the website, so if you want to listen to shows that I've done before, I'm always there. So just in case people miss this, because you know, with the podcast, etc., you know, and time zones as well, you know. So yeah, thank you for letting me have a little bit of a plug. I just wanted to say thank you for having a great show. It's it was lovely hearing you speaking about these things. God bless you, and onward and forward, my dear.
You're a star. I'm sure we'll speak another day, and thank you for calling in. I think you've been a great representative for the EDL in a time whereas all they do is throw shade onto the EDL, and for the majority of people that are busy just putting food on the table, keeping the lights on, that's all they get to hear about it. So hopefully any of you lovely listeners, you heard it here. Jeff from the EDL on Sunday Long Live Radio. Jeff, I'm going to leave you to it, and thank you, and well, I'll either see you later or catch you another Sunday.
Yeah, and no surrender ever. There you go. That's our slogan, no surrender ever. There you go, my dear.
That's brilliant. Hey, Jeff, love and peace always. See you soon.
Yeah, Love you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Friggin' brilliant, Jeff. Love it, man. Love it.
Thank you, Dave. Yeah. It's when you listen to yourself, when you think, sometimes you just don't back. It's just, you just do things spontaneous sometimes, don't you, Dave? What you think, what's on your mind. And it was so easy to talk with, you know. A couple of things that she asked me. It was just right. Everything was right. I loved it. I loved the graphics of the show. It's what I was telling her. I loved the way that it's set up. And, of course, you find the radio show. Or she has a Discord site that Gary highly recommends. So there you go. I'll be definitely listening to the live Sunday shows future. I always will, because they talk about things like we talk about on the EDL radio show. So it's good to hear that type of a radio show. I think they're broadcasting just South London, actually. I think she said just on the they come. Comes from the south, so I think it's really good. I'd say lovely lady to talk to as well, Dave, you know what I mean, and our listeners out there. So it seems like it's taking a lot of traction. I've checked it out. A lot of people liked it, Dave, gotta admit, you know. That's what it's about, isn't it, you know.
Doing
what we do, Dave, and it's good to see other people like Raybo doing a live radio show as well. So it all helps the cause, doesn't it, brother?
Yeah, and I just want to tell people, if you want to check this out on YouTube, okay, just look for, when you do the search for REA and then a space and then BOW, and that should come up for you. I'm looking at the page right now, Jeff, that featured you, and you've got 95 likes. You've only got one dislike. A lot of people were doing it.
If you see the comments section, and the thing about it, the actual chat was so positive. I didn't have anybody having a bit of a dig or anything like that. I didn't see that whatsoever. It was just great stuff, Patriot. We love your page, you know, things like that. And then you looked at the comments. I haven't seen anything negative on the comments section underneath either. But then again, you know, it's still early days, isn't it, Dave? You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I'm just looking through the comments now, man. And it's pretty much positive. And I just want to say from my own. Now this, if Ray if that's how your name is pronounced, I hope I'm doing it right. I called you Rhea at first, and I apologize if I butcher your name. But this is the one and only time that I've heard you, and I haven't heard you say your name. But yeah, I just want to say about the whole operation, Jeff. I mean, I have not been one of these people for about the past 7 or so years that's had their head glued to Fox News and to some of these other polished conservative or outlets and things of that nature. I've been in podcasting for a while. I was kind of part of what we used to call the Rainbow Coalition. That used to meet up on AC Nation with G-Ski Rocks from Atlanta and, of course, No Way 90, good friend of this show, out of Maine. And, that was like 6 or 7 years ago. And, those guys it does. And I have experience, of course, with an organization that we're going to be talking with a little bit here, guys, TECN, the Exceptional Conservative Network. They do TV, and we may well get into some of that. You never know. But Ken McClinton runs that network, and he is a fantastic host of his own show, as we know. have experience with them, with Dan Butcher, you know, who used to run High Plains Pundit Talk Radio. He does his own he does his own podcast now, but it's more locally oriented than it used to be. And of course, all of the great guys, you know, and ladies over at SHR Media, brilliant people. Each of them have come to the podcast table with their own set of talents and abilities and technical expertise as well. And over these past 7+ years, I'm not to forget the Underground Professor. Over these past 7 years, Jeff, I've seen, and you have too, man. You know this. You know, we've seen and sometimes been a part of some really horrible on-air disasters and some really great triumphs, you know, technical issues.
That's live radio for you, though, Dave.
If things can
go wrong, they can go double wrong. Things can turn out as a drama, but it's quite funny. When you listen later, it was a comedy of errors, and you know, that's what live radio is all about, and it's what I think the listeners like that. They don't really know what's going on in the background. A lot of people running around with their hair alight, but they don't hear that. They hear the soothing sounds of people talking about things, serious issues, a bit of lightheartedness as well. And that's what the live radio show is all about. It's what we do. It's really important for people out there. You know, sitting there with the kids listening and having a bit of a laugh, joke, and also talking about serious issues. That's what it's all about. It's getting out to the masses, isn't it? That's what we do.
Well,
and Ray Bo, she does a fantastic job herself, and I reckon that show will grow and grow. It's picking up traction. I mean, if you see the. It's just a great, positive radio show to listen to, Dave. You know, play big music, you know, talk about some of the issues that's been going on in the world with Tommy, this, that, and the other. And it was just really a breath of fresh air, Dave, you know.
Well, the point I was trying to make, Jeff, was that, I've seen all these things go on, and I've been a part of some of them that have gone on. The tragedies, as you say, the comedies of errors, the triumphs, and everything like that. And getting a look at this segment of that program, I have to say that the team that runs that thing, I believe there's a fella or lady, I don't know whether it's a fella or lady, you never know these days on the internet, that runs the chat portion for that show. That's brilliantly done. The whole thing is well laid out. It's one of the best I've seen, and their sound quality is just about second to none. So somebody knows how to work a mixer as well. It really was a pleasure to listen to, and I just want to say that I was impressed with the show. I was impressed with the lady's ability to interview, to do this kind of thing on the fly. It's not an easy thing to do, and she helped to bring out the best in you, Jeff.
I've got to admit,
yeah,
it's because it's the way that when you talk to some people, if you talk to any some people got a different way of on the hop. Don't forget, she was on the hop. She didn't know who was going to be calling in, didn't know
that's
what it was
point.
Going to be about. So, you know, she just took it and run with what she had with me talking about the issues. As you said, Dave, she did a fine job. As I say, I was really, really impressed, and I felt very laid back with it. You know, sometimes you feel like you're on your front foot sometimes an interview now and again, but I felt easygoing, and I wanted to get my point over, and I did. I want to speak about the injustice with Tommy, and all them points was covered. You know, was covered, and it was just it was lovely to do, Dave. It was
well, yeah,
I really
it, it, it really does. it really does take someone who has a vocation for doing that sort of thing to bring out the best in someone that they're interviewing. And yeah, as I said, it's not easy, especially when you have someone call in from out of the blue, and you can tell she's really on the hop when it comes to her fats and her instinct for what's going on socially right now in the UK and all of that. So, ma'am, from me to you, from an old podcast veteran to you, welcome, or well done, and welcome, yes. Godspeed.
She's going to go a long way, this lady, and the great the other team that's involved, whoever's involved, great. Once again for myself and Dave, the way that it's laid out, everything is so cool to look at. So me and Dave, we're really thankful that we can listen to another great radio show out there that's not mainstream media crap, isn't it, Dave? That's what it's all about.
Absolutely, Jeff. And you know what, man? We've only got 12 minutes left in the show, brother, so we may want to think about closing this fantastic thing down.
The show.
I saw that, my friend.
Thank you, Gary, for joining us, and great, sir. As
I say, appreciate
you, Gary. Thank you. The show, and he gives us some great information there, about the she's got the Discord site as well. So, as you said, highly recommend. So, I've given that a shout out a few times. So, Dave, as I say, we're down to the last 9 minutes or 8 minutes of the show. Maybe your final thoughts for this evening, and where can the great listeners find you during the week, because I know you do other bits and pieces, so would you like to tell everybody where they can find you, Dave?
I'll get right to that, brother, but first let's not forget Tommy Robinson, who is in my opinion illegally banged up in prison right now, and if you guys want to write to him, you can do this with the info that I'm going to give you. And you can use the link that I'm going to read to send him an email. So you can send him a snail mail or you can send him an email. All right. And you're going to need his name and prison number. I'm going to give those to you right now. His name is Stephen. That's Stephen. And then Yaxley, Yaxley, Lennon, Lennon. No dash in between those two. Okay. And his prison number is A2084CG. That's A as in Alpha, 2084, C as in Charlie, our executive producer, and G as in Golf. Okay, those are his name and prison number, okay? He is, if you're going to send him a snail mail, send it to HMP Belmarsh. That's Her Majesty's Prison. That's what that HMP means. That's on Western Way, Thamesmead. Now, that's spelled Thamesmead in London, and the postal code is SE28OEB. All right, now that's that is S as in Sierra, E as in Echo, 28, O as in Oscar, E as in Echo, and then B as in Bravo. So, guys, you can send him a snail mail. As Jeff says, that's a great way for him to spend his time is reading actual paper letters. But if you want to send him an email, you can send it to this following link, https://www.emailaprisoner.com. All right? Email a prisoner is all one word. Okay? And all you need for that then is his name and prison number. So, Do get hold of him, one way or the other. He needs to know that we haven't forgotten him, and we're not going to forget him. And, Jeff, with that, I'll tell people, please check out the Unpleasant Blind Guy page at Spreaker.com. My show times are at 1 p.m. Eastern in the United States, and that's 6 p.m. In the U.K., and that's Monday through Friday. And I have a Saturday show, which comes on at midnight Eastern in the United States and at 5 a.m. in the UK. The Unpleasant Blind Guy page at Spreaker.com runs through SHR Media, and I'm also available on the SHR Media YouTube page and the Western Free Radio Network. And for everybody who listens to this, to my show on the Unpleasant Blind Guy Spreaker page, remember, you can come here and listen to this podcast live at 3:30 p.m. Eastern in the United States. That's 8:30 p.m. in the UK, Thursdays and Sundays. So come and join us. Jump in the chat room and have a good time talking and everything, and we'll make you welcome. Jeff, it's been a tremendous, tremendous program remembering an unforgettable time in the history of humankind. And I just want to thank you for allowing me so much latitude today to do this. It's always an honor and a privilege to work with you, my brother. Jan, we know you're out there doing your thing, working hard.
Bless
you. Love you. All right. And I just want to say to the foot soldiers, the angels, the Yellow Vesters, the Brexiteers, all right, and all of the global patriots out there in the UK, in the United States, around the world, and yes, off Earth, be prosperous, be blessed, and no surrender. Jeff, back to you, brother. God bless you, man.
Brilliant, Dave. Brilliant. I love the way that you, your final thoughts, everything was spot on. Well done. Well said, my dear friend. As I say, the time flew by tonight. As I say, it was a very historic radio show, I would say, for 50 years since Apollo, Apollo 11 landed on the moon and the first man walked on the moon. Now, what a time. How you look back, you realise 50 years has gone by, ladies and gentlemen. But, that's it. That's we just hope that in the not-too-distant future, people be walking on Mars and set up colonies and this, that, and the other. It's an idealistic, this is what you call having an idealistic world. All this negative things out there with this cult of death, and all that. We need to put them back where they should be, and leave them there. Build a wall around them. Yeah, let's do a Donald Trump. Let's build a wall around them all day. Put them back in there and let them fester for 1,000 years until they're ready for civilization. I don't know. I don't know the answer there, but that's the way. I suppose I'm going to get some hate mail for that, Dave, but it's got to be said, isn't it, brother? You know what I mean? People love us or hate us. But once again, I've got to thank Gary, who's been sitting, sat there right at the beginning. Dave, before we end this, could you pass Gary one of our gold stars? Because he's been a star tonight. He's sat with us and he's listened to the show. So if I pass this, Dave, could you just hand it over to Gary for me, please, Dave?
There you go, brother. It's been a star-studded show tonight. You've been a star for being here, and everybody who listens, you're a star. We got Jeff Mitchell here. You know, he's a star, and I'm a star too. And in my case, I'm a true star, because you know what they call a star, or you know what a star is. You know, it's a hot ball of gas. That's me. But you know, hey.
I'm sorry, what you like,
Jeff.
God
bless you, brother.
We all laugh. But once again, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in to the English Defence League radio show with my wingman this evening, Mr. Dave Agador Milner. Everybody, whatever part of the world you live, I hope you've enjoyed the show tonight as much as we have enjoyed bringing this show to you. Very, very special show tonight. So for myself, Dave, and of course, Al Jan, bless her, they're working hard as usual. We'll see you in the very near future. So with that, no surrender, guys. And just one thing. Don't forget, we've got our website, right? If you go on the website, www.englishdefenseleague.org.uk, there's always a donate button. You could always help the cause. A couple of dollars here, a couple of quid here. It helps. It helps us fight and continue doing what we do. So for myself, Dave, and the team, everybody out there, No surrender, no surrender ever, and we've got to go underground. I've only got about a minute and a half, something like that. Anyway, cheers, guys, and we'll see you this Sunday. No surrender, no surrender ever. Cheers, Gary.
People might say that I should strive for more, but I'm so happy.
Yeah,
I can't see the same things happening here today. A show of strength with your five brigades. And I'm so happy and you're so fine. You want more money,
yeah,
you want
to
buy. My New Zealand friends was far from his friends. And the public gets what the public wants. But I want nothing. Pleasure as a hate me, I've been up for any of my hate. People might need some tension to relax me, I'm too busy dodging between the facts. To be here for what you get, you made your bed, you better lie in it. You choose your lead and the place you're trapped, and the lies will shut down and their promises come. You'll be killing machines with paper rockets and guns, and the public wants what the public gets.
Go, we've done a 2-hour show this evening, extended the show this evening, but wow, a great show of great with Dave doing his thing as well. Great slides, Dave, great scripting this evening as well, my dear friend. So anyway, we'll be back again this Sunday with another great show, so we'll have a lot more to talk about next few days. So we'll see you this Sunday. So, as I say, from myself, from Dave, and Jan, the team, we'll see you Sunday. So, this is the English Defence League radio show signing off for tonight, but we'll be back again this Sunday. And no surrender, no surrender ever. Good night, and God bless everybody.
And that is it for this time. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for listening, and may your God go with you. Goodbye. The Unpleasant Blind Guy is copyright 2019, Anno Domini. Now for Dave's Canes. Extras that help you navigate the new media world.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.
Hey, this is Michael Wright.
And I'm Shannon Wright.
Join us for The Right Way with Shannon and Mike, Monday through Thursday from 7 to 9 a.m. right here on SHR Media.
Why are they joining us?
For fun things like sports, politics,
Oh, maybe some news and entertainment?
And all kinds of other things.
Money and recipes and events, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, so join us Monday through Thursday, 7 to 9 a.m. here on shrmedia.com.
From a public locker inside a dilapidated Long Island rail station comes a show designed to piss off liberals using truth, facts, and ridicule. The Lid Radio Show, featuring the conservative voice from the People's Republic of New York, the Lid himself, Jeff Dunnett. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com. At Lid Radio, we fight for the truth, justice, and a good kosher T-bone. If you don't listen, Hillary Clinton might sneak into your bedroom in her house coat late at night and blame you for her election loss. It's the Lid Radio Show with Jeff Dunnett.
It's your business diva here, Melanie Collette. I am inviting you to a front row seat as I discuss some of the most intriguing details of wealth and finance with today's movers and shakers in the world of business. Listen in and discover financial truths on a global, domestic, and household scale. Uncover topics that will impact your wallet today and in the future. Money Talk with Melanie airs Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. East, 2 p.m. West, right here on SHR Media and High Plains Pundit Talk Radio. You can't afford to miss it.
The new show on the SHR Media Network, Sackheads Against Tyranny, on shrmedia.com. Go there quick like a bunny, 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Pacific, every Wednesday, live and direct on the SHR Media Network, shrmedia.com. Be there.
Broadcasting behind enemy lines in occupied California, a mere 2 miles from the state capital, the Bloviating Zeppelin's Berserk Bobcat Saloon Radio Show can be heard every Tuesday and Thursday night at 8 p.m. Pacific and 11 p.m. Eastern, only on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com to listen. You can also watch on the SHR Media Facebook page and the SHR Media YouTube channel. No goldfish were abused in the making of this ad.
Hey girls, Carry Girl Gear is here. More and more women every day are concealed carrying, participating in competitive shooting, and getting firearms training. It's not a boys' club anymore, and we don't have to shop in their stores anymore either. Finally, a cool and unique clothing line just for women. Dope tees and hats for the patriotic concealed carry and 2A girl. So what are you waiting for? Go check out carrygirlgear.com today.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.